I want to move on, though, to this Pennsylvania woman who turned herself into authorities, not after a crime, but after an offense some would consider even worse. She up and left her family, abandoned them, including two children. 11 years after she went missing, Brenda Heist showed up at the sheriff's office in Key Largo, Florida. This was last Friday. And we'll show you this picture here because you can see this was Heist on the left. This is back in 2002. And on the right, this is Heist today at the age of 54. Her daughter was 8. Her son was 12 when Heist chose to walk away. Her disappearance launched a swarm of local and state and federal investigators trying to figure out what happened, where did she go, interviewing all kinds of people, and ended with a declaration of her death in 2010. And just in the last hour, I talked to this Pennsylvania detective, been working this case since day one, told me about his conversation with this woman. Oh, a lot of wind here in Boston. I'm just going to hold it. And this all had to do with a pending, we're okay, had to do with a pending divorce issue and financial troubles as far as why she up and left. Take a listen.
She just left and on a split second whim and decided to just leave and turn her back on her family and on her life and pursue a life with these homeless people to hitchhike down to Florida.
So on the phone with me now is Lee Heist. This is Brenda's ex-husband, who at one point in time, sir, I know you were considered a suspect in her disappearance. Lee, you gave us this beautiful picture with, you know, your current wife and your kids with Brenda. You all are grinning from ear to ear, but I have to ask, now knowing about the fact that she just up and left, are you furious?
As more and more information seems to be coming to light, I'm very upset with what I'm hearing, especially for the sake of my children. I just had my daughter home just a little while ago from college, and we talked about it, and she's beside herself. I'm an adult. I was trying to work through it just on my own. That's my current wife, my son, my daughter, myself.
Wow. And so we reported a couple of years ago, I mean, for all intents and purposes, you could never find her. Did you ultimately just believe she was dead?
Personally, and I think many people, we felt that perhaps she had been carjacked because of where the car was found. We never knew for sure, but I really did think that she had died, and unfortunately in not a very pleasant way. This was a terrific shock just last Friday.
How, Lee, did you hear that, in fact, she's fine and turned herself into police in Florida, had a whole life?
Detective Schofield from the Lititz Borough Police Department, who has worked beyond any expectations all 11 years on this case, has never let it go. He contacted me about 8:30, 9 o'clock on Friday evening to say he needed to talk to me and wanted to speak to myself and my daughter. We met him at a restaurant. He drove all the way into King of Prussia from out in Lancaster County to talk to us in person. And we expected, as we drove to the meeting, my daughter and I expected that we were going to hear that they had recovered her body. But instead, we were told that she was, in fact, alive. So at that point, it was good news, bad news, good news that she was, in fact, alive, an opportunity for some closure with the children. Bad news is, here we go again. So that was pretty much it.
Lee, if she were to reach out to you, want to talk to you, A, would you talk to her? And B, what would the first question be that you would ask?
Well, honestly, I don't think after all of this that there anything good would come of a conversation. I don't think it would be beneficial to her, and certainly not to me, but to my kids, absolutely. And I would do whatever is necessary to make sure that if she wants and if the kids want, and it would be their decision, I would certainly make arrangements for them to meet with their mother. Absolutely.
You know, we talked to that sergeant that you talk about, Schofield, last hour, and he just sort of reiterated that she doesn't face any charges, you know, that up and walking away from your life is not against the law. And so she may reach out to your children, and you're saying that if she wants to, that she can, but you have nothing to say to her. Lee Heist, what an ordeal. Thank you so much for just jumping on the phone and just giving me your perspective. I appreciate it so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Well, it is a revived push for gun control, and for some of the people involved, this is personal. Family members of gun violence victims are taking some senators head-on, confronting them about their no vote on recent gun legislation. Will it change any votes? And is this even a fair tactic to begin with? We're going to discuss that next.